Good afternoon, everyone. This is Jeffrey Moss from Parker Dewey. Really excited to be here, and thank you so much to the folks at University of Texas at Arlington for hosting us today. Excited to talk a little bit about an incredible program they're running called the MAV Micros, and really how it can support not just the students at UTA, but also the business community within Dallas and beyond. So if we were together, I'd ask by a show of hands how many of you have heard of micro internships, but since we're not, I'll just quickly start off by discussing what is a micro internship. Micro internships are not anything new. They're not some newfangled post-COVID invention, but rather they're something that were developed about 6 years ago. And we define micro internships as short-term, paid, professional projects completed by college students or recent graduates on behalf of busy professionals. And just to unpack that a little bit, what does this mean? Well, short-term means projects that would take you or members of your team 5, 10, 20 hours to get done. Typically, we see them between 10 and 40 hours. There's no magic to that number. But think about these, again, as short-term projects. We call them the we shoulds and the I shouldn'ts. We should go research what our competitors are doing, or we should write a new article on a given topic, but we just don't have the time. Or the I shouldn'ts. I shouldn't be spending my Saturday morning cleansing the data or creating a social media calendar. While these we shoulds and I shouldn'ts might not be the best use of time for you or members of your team, for college students, including those at UTA, they provide really, really valuable experiences. And we'll talk more about that. So again, short term, meaning they're projects that typically take 10 to 40 hours. These are paid projects. So we don't believe in unpaid work, as I'm sure you don't either. So these are paid and paid fairly. The way it works is you set the price for each project. The students see the description of the project. They see how much they'll be paid. They are paid 90% of the price that you set, but it is a fixed fee that you set. So there's no back and forth negotiation or bidding. We want this to be really fair and equitable. On average, most micro internships are about $400 and typically require about 20 hours of work. And again, a lot of organizations do think in that way. They think, well, we think this project will take about 15 hours. We normally pay our interns about $20 an hour. Let's set the price as $300. Whether it actually takes the student 14 hours or 17, you're still paying that same $300. Again, making it really, really fair and equitable and easy for everyone. These are also professional assignments. And I know we talked a little bit about the we shoulds and the I shouldn'ts. This is not college students who are going to go fetch coffee or make photocopies. Now, the projects may not be the most glamorous. They're going to be in line with what you would give a recent college grad during his or her first job. And we talked about some examples before. They're also comprehensive. We found that micro internships in general, and the MAV micros in particular, are applicable for organizations ranging from one-person startups all the way to large global corporations like the one Lockheed Martin, which is the sponsor of the University of Texas Arlington's Career Center. So what we found is, again, these projects are truly applicable across company sizes, ranging the full range, but they're also applicable across departments, sales, marketing, technology, accounting. Doesn't matter what department you're in as a busy professional, you have those we should and I shouldn't needs. A couple other things worth noting, these are flexible, so they can get done year round. It's not just for the summer or winter break. We found that University of Texas Arlington students are excited to work on these projects, even if they have a full course load. They're able to work in between classes, nights, weekends, et cetera. They also can be done remote. As I mentioned, we've been doing this for 6 years, and even before COVID, we found about 97, 98% of the micro internships didn't require the student to be on site. This makes it easier for everyone. So for the student in Arlington taking classes, they're not necessarily able to get into downtown Dallas for a quick 5 or 10 hour project. It may not be geographically convenient. But what it also does is it makes it more available for you. You don't have to worry about where is the student going to sit and do we have the resources and technology for him or her to get the project done. Also lets you expand your reach. So for those companies that might be outside of the DFW area, if you're a UTA alum, for instance, and you want to provide a MAV micro to one of the students, it's a great opportunity to do so even if you're in a different geographic location. One other thing worth noting, this does not replace your existing internship program if you have one. It doesn't replace full-time hiring. This is very much used by organizations as a complement, both to get some of that work done, but also to identify, engage, and assess potential candidates for full-time roles. So again, the on-demand support is truly incredibly valuable. Again, getting that highly motivated college student to provide some help on the project is just so, so useful. Again, when you think about your backlog of all of those we shoulds and I shouldn'ts. But to the other point, it also helps you build relationships with students, students that think to work at an interesting technology firm, I have to go to Silicon Valley. No, you don't. There's great tech firms in the DFW area, or I want to do interesting strategy. I have to work for one of the strategy consulting firms. Well, guess what? Small businesses have strategy needs or marketing needs or finance needs. Here's a way to build those relationships and introduce your organization to students that may not be aware of it or aren't otherwise thinking about roles in the industry or have preconceived notions because of a consumer-facing brand. What it also lets you do is give back. Again, the University of Texas students are smart, hardworking, but for a lot of them, they've been impacted by COVID, especially during the past few years, where they've had summer internships canceled and classes taken remote and few opportunities to really explore career paths in ways that their predecessors in earlier classes have. And probably for most of you, how you did when you were in school. This becomes a great way to support those students, letting them explore different career paths, providing them with valuable ways to build their resumes and build those relationships. As I said earlier, everyone has these project needs, these we shoulds and I shouldn'ts. And we even pulled together this simple flowchart to help you think about it. Do you have something on your plate that would take you 10, 20, 30 hours to get done? Yeah, we all do. Is that a project that could be done without deep industry knowledge, without required access to anything confidential and sensitive? If it is, great. It's a perfect micro internship. If we're talking about a project where you need to go through someone's social security numbers and account numbers, if you're a financial services organization, probably not. If it's a project where you're betting the company, again, not a good micro internship. Think about all of those other low stakes, short-term projects that you have on your plate, and again, not enough hours in the day for, or just aren't the highest and best. And again, college students are super excited to work on this. So how does it all work? Well, the beauty of the MAVS micro program is it was made super easy. Essentially, you post your project, pick who you want, engage with the student and the work gets done, and that's it. And we'll talk through all of those steps in a second. But a couple things to note, part of the reason that we're so honored to partner with the University of Texas at Arlington is that behind the scenes, we're able to provide all of those supports. So for instance, when the students are executing the MAV micros, they're not on your payroll, you're not filling out 1099s or W-2s. You're simply paying Parker Dewey and we're paying the student. And again, the student receives 90% of that fee. That other 10% we do retain, and that covers our cost of having the student on our books. That covers our cost of all of the accounting and the like. But what's also very important to know is, say you're working with one of the students on the MAV micro and he or she does an amazing job, and it's someone you want to recruit and potentially hire for a traditional summer internship or a full-time role, you don't owe any additional money. We're not a staffing firm or a temp agency. We're just trying to collaborate with the university to help create these equitable pathways as a way to help the university students, but also help organizations like yours. It's also important to note that we have an entire on-demand support team behind the scenes. The client success team is there to answer any questions and provide whatever help you need along the way, though it's pretty easy. As we said, we made it simple to post the MAV micros. You can simply post them on demand. You can craft your own project, or you can use these templates that we developed in partnership with the University of Texas at Arlington with some of the most common projects. And again, these are all just a few samples. If you have any of those needs or questions, you can simply fill out the form at the top, and we're happy to give you other suggestions on specific projects that we've seen. Again, having done this for 6 years, we've pretty much seen it all. From a timing perspective, we suggest posting the MAV micros typically between 48 and 72 hours before you want it to start. So this isn't something you need to think about, well, what do I need next summer? What do I need over winter break? These are projects that you need right now. I'm going to a conference next week and I need help crunching the list. or there was an interesting article in the local newspaper about a given topic, we want to draft a response. Or we have a series of customer meetings coming up, we need help updating a presentation. All of those are perfect examples and projects you could post today, have a student working on them tomorrow or the next day, and have them on your plate, sort of back and finished within a few days after that. And again, we'll show you all of the details. Once those projects are posted, the students see them. Obviously, the students at the University of Texas at Arlington see all of the projects. You can limit it to just those students, and we'll show you how. But some of the things we're also proud of is this allows you to really support diversity, equity, and inclusion initiatives and reach students who may be from a certain geography but attending university elsewhere. But again, it's a single platform that lets you do this. Once your projects are posted, the students apply. And what that means is you're not flipping through thousands of resumes or LinkedIn profiles, trying to guess who's going to be interested. The students see the description of the project. So in this example with Wayne Enterprises, it's a content creation. They want someone to draft an article on the topic. They see the start date and due date. So if they're in the middle of finals week or just have a super busy schedule, they're not going to apply. They see how much they'll be paid. And if they're interested in the project, again, they apply for it. What we're also doing in partnership with the UTA is we're able to feature companies that are providing these projects through the MAV Micros program to, again, further engage the students. And this is incredibly useful, again, for organizations that may not have the brand recognition of the students or are trying to look beyond a traditional recruiting pool. So for a finance company, here's a way to access liberal arts majors who might not be thinking about a role in financial services, or for an organization looking for students with strong marketing skills, well, that doesn't necessarily mean just marketing majors. Here's a way to engage the liberal arts student, or for a technology company that's having trouble competing for top tech talent, here's a great way of introducing your brand to those tech students who don't recognize what opportunities are necessarily available in the DFW area. Once the students apply, you see those students' profiles. Again, you're not flipping through thousands of resumes trying to guess. You see where the student attends university. You can pull their resume and LinkedIn. But one of the things we found is most important is every project has at least one short answer question. Why do you think you'd be a good fit? Why should we pick you? Now, you can ask a second or third question or however many you want. How would you approach this? Why does this interest you? What are your career goals? You can ask those questions as well. What's really important about those questions is while everyone might have a perfect resume that's been screened to perfection, especially given the amazing job the Lockheed Martin Career Center does, doesn't necessarily mean that the student has attention to detail, doesn't necessarily mean that the communication skills are as strong as we would like. Well, these short answer questions become a great way of teasing those things out, of looking at the student beyond a GPA. Again, we've all hired folks that we thought look great on paper, and then when they start the role, it's not a great fit. Or we go into an interview and realize it. But we also know that we've certainly filtered people, maybe because they didn't have a high enough GPA or didn't have a major that sounded like the role we were hiring for. Well, what we found is these short answer questions let you find those individuals. Again, someone like Legend who has a really, really thoughtful answer, sure, let's give Legend a shot. Doesn't matter where he went to school or his GPA. Versus the student who wrote, I go to Harvard and have some free time. And I'm not going to pick that student. I wish I was making it up, and it's nothing against Harvard, but we've seen those things. Or answers to the questions that are riddled with typos. Again, that sends a signal, and a signal that's not necessarily captured on a resume or in an interview. Once that happens, the work gets done. Again, we want this to be easy. You engage with the student how you want. You want to hop on a quick Zoom call? Great. You want to send an email with a quick overview. If they're local and you want to invite them into the office, you certainly have that opportunity. But our goal and the goal of UTA is to get out of the way. We don't want to create friction. So while we're there to provide whatever ongoing support, answer questions, et cetera, that you need, we don't want to get in the way. If you're an organization, again, that uses SharePoint or Slack, feel free to invite them to your Slack if you want, or send the email, as I said, whatever is easiest for you. We've also found that the MAV micros and micro interns in general are incredibly motivated, which is why we've seen over 98% success on the projects, meaning the UTA students exceed the expectations. And we get feedback after each project is done. And the reason they're so motivated is, yes, they're getting paid, but they're not doing it just about the money. They're doing it because they want the experience. They want the opportunity to build their resume. They want to learn about different roles in different industries as part of their career exploration. And that's really, really vital. Again, if you think about the benefits of UTA's EDGE program and the internship program as a way to explore, this complements it so well. Here's a way to try a series of different projects in different industries for different companies to really hone in as a student on what interests me. What that also means for the companies here, it means that when you ultimately make that full-time hire of students who have done micro internships, not necessarily just with your organization, but with others in general, they're going to stick around. And we found over 98% of students stay at least 18 to 24 months after being hired for a full-time role. Now, I'm still bummed about that other 2%, but it compares very, very favorably with the fact that 55% of all recent college grads leave their first job within the first year. And again, programs like the MAV Micros and the EDGE internship program at UTA really provide an incredible opportunity for students to do that exploration before committing to their first job, which makes, again, hiring UTA students so valuable. So a couple of FAQs that always come up, and again, we'll share the presentation afterwards. You define the project. You can use our templates as a starting point or in total. Again, we've been doing this a long time. You can edit or refine them, or you can also define the project from scratch. And as I said, feel free to do it yourself. It takes less than 2 minutes to get it posted, or reach out using the form, and we're happy to share examples of similar projects we've seen done. You set the price for each project. It's a fixed fee. Again, typically 200 to 600 bucks tends to shake out about 20 bucks an hour for the estimated number of hours. The only place we get concerned is if it seems unfair. So if you're saying, I think this will take you 20 hours and we'll pay you 50 bucks, we will follow up with you and say, hey, we don't think that's a fair price, and we'll make some suggestions. Again, this is not a platform to take advantage of college students, but rather one that helps companies and helps students in a positive way. The students are also not your employees. They're not your interns, contractors, apprentices, or anything else. You're not payrolling them. Parker Dewey is the employer of record for these micro internships, making it very, very easy for you. So you can just put it on a credit card or a check or whatever's easiest. You select the micro intern you want. We're not telling you who's assigned to you. And then all of the students are under NDA and legal assignment. And again, in 6 years of doing it, we've had no issues with this, meaning the students take these projects very, very seriously, and they understand the consequences of violating the NDAs. That said, these tend to be projects that don't require access to anything super sensitive. These are projects that, again, you would give to a new hire or a summer intern without stressing out. But again, we like to make sure we're very much belts and suspenders. And this is probably the slide I'm most proud of, that this drives real sustainable impact. And I know we have a mix of organizations on this call, both large global organizations and smaller businesses. And to be frank, we work with the full set. We work with organizations ranging from one-person startups to these global organizations. And the only reason we have the big names on here is just candidly because organizations have heard of them. And we're seeing that happen again, where this is leading real, real positive impact for the students. Companies are creating new roles. But one of the ones I'd like to highlight is M. Holland, an organization you may not have heard of. It's a Chicago-based plastics company. And one of the challenges they faced was recruiting college students for the summer internship and full-time positions because students hadn't heard of it. Or they had preconceived notions of what it meant to work at a manufacturing company or a plastics company. Well, they used micro internships as a way to break through that, to introduce their brand to students who might not be aware, or students who wanted to remain in Chicago but thought they had to go to New York to do interesting marketing work. Here was a great way to do that. Or an organization like JLL, where again, students weren't thinking about real estate, or they were only recruiting from certain schools, or even down in the DFW area, Pepsi. Again, here's a great way to help those students who might be student athletes and are unable to participate in traditional summer internships, or might be working while they're in school. So the traditional summer internship may not have worked. This becomes a great way of, again, engaging those students. So what now? Well, really simple. You can post a micro internship today. You can visit the MAV Micro site, and we'll share that at the end of the recording, or you can see it at the bottom. You can ask any questions, let us know if you have other project requests, but feel free to get started. And with that, if anyone has any questions, we can be reached, again, we'll share the presentation afterwards. We can be reached at Parker Dewey. And I know the UTA team is also happy to answer any questions. But again, think about those we shoulds and I shouldn't you have on your own plate, or share it with your colleagues. Let them know. Next time someone comes to you and says, oh, I'm trying to get this done, but I don't have the time or the resources, let them know the MAVS micro program through the University of Texas at Arlington is just an incredible opportunity. And with that, this completes the webinar. Thank you so much for your time.